Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. We today are going to be decorating the Grinch gingerbread house. So as you guys know, if you've watched a few of my Vlogmas videos, Anthony loves the Grinch. It's his favorite Christmas movie. He is obsessed. So when we saw this, we thought this was perfect.
Not this one, by the way.
Okay, the
one with Jim Carrey.
Okay.
Sorry, just have to throw that out.
Yeah, I haven't seen this one.
A little disappointed in myself that I haven't seen it, but
yeah,
we'll see.
So we got to the CVS and they only had one left. So the real point of this video was to kind of do a battle. There was only one left and we couldn't pass it up. So we had to get it. So what we're gonna do is kind of do it right down the middle. So he'll decorate this side, I'll decorate this side, and then we'll see who did a better job instead of doing two separate. So yeah, hopefully this is entertaining. Also, we're going to kind of talk about a topic. I did put a thing to send me questions for a Q&A on my story, but I'm gonna take like one of those that can be like deeply elaborated on, and we're just gonna talk about it here so that you're not just watching us build this. So we're gonna get started and see you in the next clip. Seeing the back side of it, but yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and decorate this side, Anthony will do that side, and then we'll see who does better, I guess.
Well, if it keeps falling apart like it was before.
I know, it kind of keeps sliding. The icing doesn't stick very well. This is gonna be hard. We don't need that.
So I can see. Oh. It's for me, it's not for me. I don't think we'll do that because I'm gonna need some of this for sure.
Okay, so while we're doing this, I kind of want to talk about how do you keep like a relationship healthy and I guess still exciting after being together for so long? Because we've been together now for like, what, 6.5?
Oh, good God.
6.5 years?
Yeah.
I figure like we can kind of dig pretty deep into that. I think something about us is we're extremely low maintenance people. I think in terms of relationship as well, I think that we both are homebodies almost, so like it's not hard to keep us both happy and like we don't have to do extravagant things to enjoy each other's company or anything like that. And like we don't really do date nights much.
We're together kind of like all the time. Like it's like, I don't know, I don't.
So I'm trying to think of it as.
We're probably strange in that
regard. I know.
Like, we don't like need date night. Like no. I hang out with you pretty much all day, every day. And like when we go out to eat whenever, like. I kind of consider those as dates, I guess, like,
yeah.
Which is at least once a day for the most part. Like, we go out and do something together, you know? So, like, we're super low-maintenance people, so I think it's pretty easy for us to kind
yeah.
of, you know?
It's hard.
We're just easy around each other.
Yeah, I think that our personalities go very, very well together. We enjoy each other's company so much that just, like, doing nothing together is enough, in
yeah.
my opinion.
100%.
So I know that that's not always the case for some couples, but I truly think that if you need special things, like, I feel like maybe that you're not, like, soulmates. If that makes sense.
That's...
It's hard to explain because I don't want to go around, like, shitting on people's relationships, but, like, I've never struggled to keep the flame there, keep the spark there, like,
ooh.
Guys, this is really difficult. The freaking icing that they gave us doesn't work as
well. It's like dried up almost already, yeah.
So, that's that.
Well, I'm not gonna try to paint my icing on, so I'm gonna go one at a time, so ours will be different anyway. So.
Oh, good. I don't know, guys. I feel like we have a very different relationship where, like, it works. And I don't really even...
So wait, to your point, it's hard for us to answer that where we don't struggle to, like,
yeah,
keep things
it's never
like,
been a thought
I don't know if I
issue.
Go out of my way to keep things interesting. Like, we have all the same interests, we do all the same stuff. Like, yeah, don't get me wrong, there's a lot of repetition in what we do, and, you know.
But I think we're, like, both okay with that, you know?
Yeah, 100%. We're pretty slow-paced people at the end of the
we're
day.
We're both, like, satisfied with the life that we do live, so, like... It's not like we're like needing more all the time.
Yeah.
So it's very hard because I know that's not always the case with some people, but I honestly feel like if you're with your best friend or like soulmate, if you think that's a thing. It's just so simple that you don't even have to think of these things. Like, I don't have tips, like we don't do anything special to keep things interesting and healthy, I guess.
Yeah, I mean,
they just are.
We genuinely enjoy each other's company all the time. So I guess the best advice would be try to pick somebody that you know you're gonna be able to be around all the time, especially when you get to the point where you're living with them.
Cause like we live together, we work together, we train. Yeah.
I just think, you know what, I guess the best advice it could be is we just know each other so well now. Like, I know when it's time to, like, leave Paige alone, let her be. And, I mean, there's sometimes when we go, like, an hour or two without even speaking to each other. Not, like, not because anything's wrong or anything, but just because we know each other. It's like...
Yeah, like, we're both doing our own thing.
Even though we live in a one-bedroom apartment, like, we know how to give each other space.
Yeah.
So...
We don't need to be up each other's asses all the time.
Yeah, so I think maybe on the flip side, that's helpful. Like, make sure you're giving each other space. You don't want to be, you know, locked at the hip all the time. What is this jelly nonsense?
I'm cheating because I'm using things that didn't come with the kit. So this is the food coloring. So
I win by default already.
I know, I'm cheating. This is the food coloring that we got for our other frosting. And I'm just kind of using it to, like, draw with because I don't know. I want to make designs.
What's like a question you get often?
Off-season, weight gain, and stuff like that. As I'm licking my frosting fingers.
How do you deal with it?
Everyone struggles a lot mentally with it. And, like, guys struggle too. So I know that you get in your, head sometimes with it. So maybe your tips would help as well. But that's, like, literally my number one thing. And, like, I feel like I talk about it a lot. But people still ask about it. So I guess I haven't talked about it enough.
I mean, I think everybody, you and I, can attest. Certainly go through that. Truthfully, I mean, it just comes down to really how bad you want the specific goal that you're looking to achieve.
In the future.
Yeah, it's
not
like...
Not fast return.
Yeah, I always, I have bad body image days, if you want to call them that. Don't get me wrong. But I've come to the point where I've accepted, and I'm not saying, like, I love my body where I am right now, but I've accepted that, especially in my world, because I'm trying to put on muscle mass, you're going to get chubby before you get big. It's just how it goes. You got to go through all the different seasons to eventually get to that ultimate goal you want to get to. Whether it's weight loss, whether it's weight gain, whether it's muscle gain, muscle loss, whatever it is that you want to achieve, it's going to take time and you're going to go through a lot of ups and downs to get there.
Yeah, I mean, you have, like, you can't grow without having to go through that rough.
You just have to be willing to do it. You just have to be willing to know that you're not going to feel your best in the gym, at least from a visual perspective, all the time. But I think you have to, like, really harp on the positives that come with it, where I'm as strong as I ever have been in the gym. I get to eat a lot more freely right now. You got to try to weigh the pros and the cons and just try to keep yourself in a positive mind state. Not worry about too much what you're looking like. Worry about how you're feeling.
Yeah.
And then I promise you, like I said, Paige has been going through a lot of this off season as well. You're going to shock yourself. The next time you do lean out or you decide to put on size, however, when you finally do achieve that goal, it's going to feel that much better because you know you pushed through that tough
period. Yeah. I've said it before, like, if you want to make progress, that you have to go through that uncomfortable phase. If you don't want to grow and you don't want to make progress, like, then that's where you can stay in that maintenance, like, stay where you're at, but, like, if you have a goal to put on size, there's no way to do that besides eating more and busting your ass. But with eating more comes fat gain. And no matter what, it'll come.
And I think a big thing is, like, for a lot of people, like, all this stuff takes time.
So much time.
Paige and I are a few years into this now, and we're still not nearly where we want to be, Be willing to go. It's a long journey, whichever way you're going. And you have to be willing to just... I think it's why... So many people talk about it, like, it's got to be a lifestyle for you.
Yeah.
It's got to be the long game. Like, I'm looking at 5-10 years down the road from now for the physique that I'm looking to attain.
Right.
So you got to think like that, but attack every day as if it's going to happen tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Because you have to still remain serious, even though, like, it's far and whatever. Like, for me, like, I can't just go on off season like, oh, I'm not competing for another 8 months. Like, let me just dick around and eat whatever I want. You still have to remain very disciplined and, like, still eye on the goal and eye on the prize at all times. How you treat your off season is just as important as how you treat your prep, so.
Yeah. And it does come with sacrifices. I think that's what you have to, before even getting involved in in fitness, you have to understand that it does come with sacrifices.
I'm also just like I said, I'm a bad person to ask about all this because I have a really like kind of no bullshit attitude, and
I agree. You hold yourself to a super high standard.
Anthony hears me complain more than anyone about my how I look, how I feel, and I gotta say, I forgot to mention this, but not everyone is. I don't want to say sound like an asshole, but not everyone is as lucky as I am to have someone who is extremely comforting, and like he tells me how much he loves my off-season body, and just he makes me feel really good about it. So like that is huge for me. So having that like support system, and that's huge. And I know not everyone has that, so I am extremely blessed in that way. But even though I have people like him making me feel better about the situation, and I do complain to him about it, but like in my head, like I know you just have to suck it up. Like I'm having a bad body image day, like get over it. There's no reason in sitting and feeling so sorry for yourself and ooh, like I don't feel good, I don't feel like I have so much self-love today. Like you're making yourself miserable, so that's your own fault. You don't have to focus on your appearance so much, you can focus on other things. Yeah, I just feel like I'm a bad person to ask because I don't have tips, I don't have anything. I just am like, get over it or like move on, suck it up. I don't know.
Yeah,
like,
or feel that emotion and then move on. Like that's it. Like you don't dwell on it.
Like great, you had a bad day.
What are you
gonna
do about it?
You're gonna drag it on for 3 months? Like no.
If it bothers you that much, go and do something productive.
Then change
about it.
Yeah.
If you're having a bad image day, go and take a walk. Go and do some cardio. Like do something about it. Don't just sit there and think about it. If it's really bothering you that much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then this is. I mean, we're being super blunt here, but.
But that's how. But that's
it,
just
but
how
really,
I look at this
really
situation.
It's really how it is. Yeah.
Like you can't. You gotta just. If it's something that you really want and you're really passionate about, I feel like that's how you look at it as. Like you know, it's part of the process, and you gotta just deal with it. Obviously, some days are going to be easier than others, but, like, it's all, that's just how this game works. But, yeah, so that's another, that's huge, and I don't, and, like, people are like, give tips on self-love and all that. Like, I am no expert in that department. I have a lot of struggles every single day. I literally have a negative thought about myself. I don't know, it's always a work in progress, and you kind of just gotta, like, I guess, bring yourself back to reality and, like, just think about all the other shit going on in life, and like you're gonna just sit and like woe is me about your physique when really I'm sure it's pretty impressive still. This should be the least of your worries, like it's really not a big deal. So you gained 20 pounds, okay, and there's so much worse that's going on, that could be going on.
Yep.
That, like for you to be so focused on that and so like upset and letting that dictate your life is just, if you think about it, it's so silly. You gotta just kind of bring yourself out of that mindset and realize how I guess ridiculous it is, because it is pretty ridiculous if you think about it. Like Anthony said, I'd like to focus on my performance, because when you're in prep your performance goes down, so it's fun to be strong, it's fun to feel physically better in the gym, maybe not feel like you look your best, but you feel your best. You're fueled, full of food, strong. You gotta just shift the focus.
Yep. I suck at this.
So do I.
Get the Grinch up there. You won because you cheated.
You were more creative, though. How do I... He's not gonna stay.
Should we put him in the front yard?
Yeah. But first, we have to finish.
I'm actually pretty proud of this.
Guys, we suck. What are you proud of?
I'm proud of that stayed together.
Me too. And we totally half-assed it, and you know what? Too bad. This was really hard, guys. I gotta say. Because honestly, I wasn't very happy with the decoration. Like, what they gave. They gave the worst candies ever.
We should have got some other,
candies?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know it was gonna be so bad. You didn't even finish your house at all.
Ooh, before it falls apart, look, we had a split in the ceiling there.
How's it look?
So we got Mr. Grinch right there.
He's at the front door.
So this is Anthony's side. Turn that thing. So this is Anthony's side. Yeah, we kind of half-assed this, huh?
No, but
so
you did it the more normal
This was the
one.
Candy that it came with. Whatever these hard candies are.
Suck.
Gumdrops and candy canes and the jelly Mr. Grinch. So we split it down the middle. But we got my little gumdrop shrubbery here.
Yours is that's very smart. Unique.
And then my ceiling decorations. Then we'll swing over to Paige's side. Yeah, give it a little spin. So she cheated, like I said.
I used other things, so I don't know if
And used, like, this gel stuff that did not come with the kit. So I think I win.
He wins by default, but hopefully you guys think it's beautiful.
But yeah, yours is pretty.
Thanks, babe.
And that's all. Oh, you even did these windows,
huh? I tried.
Wow.
Try to go above and beyond.
Yeah, this was way less fun than I thought it was going to be.
Same, it was way harder. It wasn't as fun as when I was once a young lad.
A young lad. All right, well.
Comment below your thoughts. I know I'm a cheater, but I tried.
There's right? 3-year-olds that can do a better job than us.
Yeah, but, probably. But that's okay. Yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. It actually wasn't as fun as I thought it was gonna be, but it's Vlogmas, so it's going
not,
up.
I'm just not really an arts and crafts kind of guy.
I am, but that was hard and sticky and messy. So love you guys. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.
Bye, guys.